as frontline warriors, even taking risk of your life, you are serving the society. I really appreciate all of you. As a matter of fact, other diseases are different compared to COVID. First of all, we have to protect ourselves, then we have to serve others. While doctors, nurses, paramedical staff, other frontline warriors, even ambulance staff, bringing COVID patients to hospitals, all these people are taking heavy risk. And at the same time, they have done their best. This meeting is, I want to listen from you. Anyway, we are all talking every day. My idea is, under these circumstances, very crucial juncture, what can we do, all of us together? Even other countries also are watching. Wave one, wave two is going on. Some of the countries, they are able to go for vaccination. According to me, as a leader who is visualizing, vaccine is very, very important. If you see, sometimes it is a coincidence. In 1997, after information technology, I wanted to promote biotechnology. That is how Genome Valley has come. In Genome Valley, Bharat Biotech has started. Today they are able to produce vaccine, that is only the vaccine, indigenous. We are proud of that. Recently, if you see, MedTech zone in Visakhapatnam. 4 years back or 5 years back, I started that MedTech park. It's a 200 acres of land. Plug and play. With all the infrastructure we created there, sheds, ready-made sheds, and also R&D facility, marketing facility, warehousing, convention center, and also hotels, all these things. Anybody wanted to go for production, any medical device or equipment, they can do very short time. This is how we created MedTech Park. What I wanted to request all of you, one is how to handle COVID-19. That is very, very important. And at the same time, there are two ways. One is preventive, what to do. Short term, medium term, and long term. If you see here today, we are having a panic reaction. Oxygen is not available. Beds are a problem. Even ventilators is a problem. There is a mad rush to the hospitals. Even house quarantine, in the initial stage, people will diagnose and take precautions. Throughout house quarantine, we can cure so many people. We have done one pilot. Nearly 228 people we have identified. One Mr. Lokeshwar Rao, who is NRI, and also other doctors, local doctors. Doctors are of the patient choice, and also party is suggesting those who are all coming forward to serve the people. All these people are giving medication for them. In this, 49 people are cured, and also remaining people are getting treatment. There is no mortalities as on today. This is one model we are doing. Now, on the base of this data, this call center, or you may call, we made it a caption also, help, hope, cycle. In this, we are getting so many calls. We are trying desperately. One is beds, oxygen beds, oxygen cylinders, all these things we are getting. Most of the problems we are unable to solve. Desperately, we are trying our level best to get beds. Everywhere there is a response, beds are not there. If you get vacant, then we'll inform you. But only 15-20% of the problems we are able to solve. In the initial stage, those who are able to diagnose and inform us, day one, we are treating them. That is giving better results. What I want to request all of you, what is the best way to all of us as to focus? And then on the basis of that, according to me, from the beginning, I'm saying at that time, we were all going on talking one thing, mask to protect us, to protect others, then social distance, under the same time, sanitization, every time we have to sanitize ourselves. This is the beginning we used to promote. Today, vaccine, vaccine, vaccine. If you go for vaccine, then that is the safety. Even people will get COVID, and at the same time, it will have a mild impact. If two doses, if everybody will take, then they are safe. Even there is no guarantee that they may not get it, so many people are getting. But at the same time, mild effect, and also with the light medication, they are able to cure. So, wave one, if you see, 60 years and above, people are vulnerable. Obesity is a problem. All these things, even other problems are there, it will complicate. Today, wave two, it is dangerous for 20 and above also. All of a sudden, they are becoming sick. By diagnosis, immediately 2-3 days, they are collapsing. And so many people are dying. It's a very bad situation. Even experts are saying, wave three, even children are going to affect. So with this, what I want to request all of you, what way we can take it forward, how to protect our people, first of all, how to protect ourselves, and how to protect people. That is the major issue for all of us. Even on vaccination also, if you see, if you plan properly, it will take so much of time. Our population, huge population, 130 crore, 1300 million population. If you wanted to give two doses, even children now, you have to give, and also you have to get it, test all these things. Then only we can give it to them. But at the same time, manufacturing facilities, scaling and execution is a big problem. How to do that? Where to focus? How to focus? How to bring awareness among people? And also how to put pressure on governments also? All these things, you want to protect yourself. Government policies are very important. Public policies are important. Even government of India saying 45 and above will give vaccine. 18 and above, state governments can execute vaccine program. State governments are saying 18 and above can wait. First we'll give 45 and above. Now even those who can buy and vaccinate, they are restricting. They won't protect people. And at the same time, anybody wanted to go for vaccination with their own money, they are saying we are not giving permission. This type of restrictions are there. But at the end of the day, every human life is very, very important. How to save human life, how to save lives of all people. So this is where we want to discuss with you all. There is no politics. And at the same time, without government supports, we cannot achieve it. If government is not in a position to realize, all of us has to continuously lobbying, put pressure, and also what all possible, we have to do our best to protect society. This is the issue we are having. Now I am very happy, people like all of you, continuously, we have to raise the issue, talk to others, what all possible, we will do our best, and at the same time, we have to raise our voice and also convince governments to save the society. That is the main motive. That's where I really welcome all of you. Every day there is a panic reaction. Even if you can go through the TVs and also people are how people are vulnerable, the behavior of people and the suffering, all these things, very bad situation. So I want to invite all of you to express your views. What is short term, medium term, and long term, how to overcome COVID-19. I thank all of you. We are doing this program on behalf of NTR Memorial Trust. NTR Trust has done so many service programs earlier also. Krishna floods, we have dealt very well. Uttarakhand floods, at that time, we organized flights from Dehradun. And we lost mile, we organized cars, we took them safely to their residences also, native places. Like there are so many programs we have done. There is one more program we are thinking. Tomorrow, WhatsApp bot system we have established. Anybody is having a symptoms, they can interact. They can send all the information. Then local doctors and central team, they will go through all this data. They will guide them, which are all the precautions they have to take. And watch them continuously, monitor them. And any problem, they will refer to near to hospitals also.